Greetings. If you or your spouse is affected by infertility, particularly age-related or secondary, it may be connected in large part to nutrition-related conditions such as chronic undernutrition, food allergies, digestive disorders, pelvic constriction, metabolic syndrome, circulation inhibitors, overhydration, and fertility disruptors in presumably healthy foods and supplements. Let's take a look at these conditions one by one. Undernutrition is a borderline state between adequate nutrition and malnutrition. Even subclinical, marginal undernutrition may precipitate male and female infertility for the exact same reasons that outright malnutrition causes amenorrhea in women and impotence in men. Besides infertility, spontaneous miscarriages, and preterm births, maternal undernutrition is also behind some of the nastiest congenital birth defects such as spina bifida and heart defects or neurological disorders such as autism. Next on my list are food allergies to common foods such as eggs, milk, wheat, soluble fiber, soy, peanuts, tree nuts, and shellfish. Besides causing intestinal inflammation, blocking off nutrients, and contributing to undernutrition, food allergies eventually culminate in systemic inflammation that may also affect the lining of the cervix, uterus, and fallopian tubes, and in turn block the passage of the sperm towards the egg. Systemic inflammation may also prevent the implantation of the fertilized egg in the endometrium or cause spontaneous miscarriage that is easy to confuse with a scheduled period. In men, inflammation may obstruct sperm-carrying ducts and in turn damage the sperm and dramatically reduce its count and motility. Pelvic constriction is the next possible culprit. Reproductive organs share the abdominal cavity with the stomach and the intestines. When these organs expand in size from excess foods, fluids, gases, stools, and inflammation, the intestines distend and protrude further down into the pelvic region and may obstruct reproductive organs with their substantial weight and bulk. The ensuing constriction may affect the pickup of the ovulated egg by the fallopian tube from the surface of the ovary, or cause the obstruction of fallopian tubes and the uterus in women, or sperm-carrying ducts in men. Digestive disorders are naturally next because they are often precipitated by undernutrition, overhydration, food allergies, and pelvic constriction. They range from heartburn to irritable bowel syndrome and everything in between, and diminish fertility by interfering with digestion and assimilation of essential nutrients such as fatty and amino acids, vitamins, minerals, and microelements that are central for fertility, critical for safe pregnancy, and vital for lactation. Next in line is metabolic syndrome because it disrupts endocrine functions and impacts body weight. If, for example, you are underweight, your body may not be producing enough hormones essential for ovulation and fertilization. Alternatively, if you are overweight, your body may be overproducing estrogen that in turn may disrupt ovulation or provoke miscarriage. In either case, you also may be affected by a range of related conditions commonly associated with infertility such as thyroid disorders, adrenal dysfunction, prediabetes, diabetes, and some others. Next in line are circulation inhibitors caused by foods, yet another poorly recognized condition that affects ovaries and testes and contributes to infertility in major ways. It is, for example, a well-known fact that cutting blood flow to testes and ovaries leads to their shrinkage. The two factors that connect nutrition and circulation are elevated insulin, a vasoconstricting hormone, and triglycerides or blood lipids because they increase the viscosity of blood. Acting together, elevated insulin and triglycerides aren't really potent enough to obstruct blood flow in larger vessels, but not so in the tiny capillaries that nourish egg, sperm, and hormone-producing cores of the testes and the ovaries. Deficient hormones, low sperm count, and a failure to ovulate are the most likely outcomes of poor ovarian and testicular microcirculation. Overhydration is next, and it is one of the most prevalent contributors to infertility. Overhydration is particularly widespread in the United States because of the systematic overconsumption of bottled water, milk, tea, coffee, juices, sodas, and foods naturally high in water, such as soups, fruits, and vegetables. Then water absorbs from your intestines into the blood. It shifts the blood chemistry. To restore proper balance, the body immediately instructs your bones to release extra ions of calcium and magnesium from bone matrix, a process known as bone resorption. When too much water is consumed, this otherwise normal condition causes gradual depletion of calcium and magnesium and results in osteopenia or low bone density. Because calcium and magnesium are also required for building up the fetus and turning out a large volume of breast milk, the circuit breakers inside the body may prevent fertility or cause miscarriage when these minerals are depleted, hence the inability to conceive or carry pregnancy to term. Frequent urination, low bone density, scoliosis, periodontal disease, receding gums, tooth loss, and lactation problems in prior pregnancies are the most apparent early symptoms of calcium and magnesium depletion related to overhydration, undernutrition, and digestive disorders. Last in my list are fertility disruptors. These are the foods that contain animal estrogen, estrogen-like substances, or growth and lactation-stimulating hormones. Commercial dairy and soy are two such foods with the potential to disrupt ovulation, damage sperm production, provoke miscarriage, and cause birth defects. Despite this obvious contraceptive and teratogenic properties, soy and dairy are broadly recommended before and during pregnancy. You can find a detailed list of secondary fertility disruptors on my website. Unfortunately, when some or all of these nutrition-related conditions, disorders, and disruptors are present in your diet and affect your health, you can take fertility-enhancing drugs, fertilize eggs in vitro, and implant embryos all you want, but as long as your body isn't ready to conceive or keeps rejecting the embryo or self-aborts the fetus, all these efforts and expenses may end up wasted. So before you decide on investing yet another umpteen thousands into uncertain and risky fertility treatments, do the least expensive and most prudent thing first. Begin eliminating nutrition-related factors behind low sperm count, female infertility, miscarriages, and birth defects. Once your bodies are primed for peak conception, you may start expecting the following undeniable benefits of fertility-centric nutrition. First, you may conceive naturally and spontaneously on your own, or improve the outcomes of fertility treatments by a significant margin. Second, you are less likely to miscarry or deliver a premature and underweight child because preparing your body in advance with fertility-centric nutrition reduces most of these risks. Third, your child is less likely to be born with non-genetic birth defects or neurological disorders such as autism that may be related to maternal undernutrition. Fourth, you are less likely to give birth to an overweight infant and irreversibly harm your vagina and anorectal organs while delivering or require a C-section and face all of the related to risks and complications. Fifth, shortly after the delivery, your breasts will be chock full of high-quality milk so you can provide your so hardly fought for child with nature's intended diet for as long as you wish and without sacrificing your bones, teeth, joints, and good looks in the process. Six, your lasting health, happiness, and vigor after the childbirth are also the foundation of a successful marriage. Countless families are ruined by postpartum depression, chronic fatigue, perennial migraine, premature aging, and an ensuing loss of interest in enjoying sex with one spouse. The seventh and the final point, besides improving the vitality of one's sperm, fertility-centric nutrition also boosts the overall health, energy, stamina, libido, and the well-being of that-to-be. To learn more about nutrition-related disorders behind infertility, miscarriages, birth defects, and autism, and how to reverse and prevent them, please visit my website. In turn, I look forward to helping you and your spouse to overcome nutrition-related fertility disorders and fulfill your dreams of giving birth to a healthy child and enjoy the process.